era is, you know, a lot of these conferences have moved online, and there's not, you know, there's no physical conferences there. And I think we all miss meeting people face to face and have those kind of like, you know, kind of face to face connections. So hopefully we'll be able to continue like real conferences like DEF CON, and we'll have real, you know, like people fly in from around the world to the ICON conference next year. So we'll see how that goes.
Now, can you quickly run through all the new additions coming to ICON 2.0? You mentioned you're changing from Python to Golang. Any other updates in terms of the tech?
Yeah, sure. So I guess I should have given a bit more background, but the biggest difference between ICON 1 and ICON 2 is the new language. Like I mentioned, it's built on Go. It's much more faster, much more stable than Python. Python was a great, simple and basic programming to get a project going. But using it gets very complicated. And if you have to build a more complex system and custom modules, it gets very challenging. So over the years, ICON has become an extremely complex piece of software, and ICON 2.0 brings like much more flexibility to what we want to do for the future. So when you talk about advantages, I would say there are three key advantages. The first is the scalability. And we could break this into a couple of parts. The first part, development is much faster due to the simplicity of Go. So while you're using Python, yes, Python was a great way to get the project up and running, but as things get more complicated, you know, maintaining and scaling a Python-based system has been quite challenging internally. So we saw this. It's not that we faced a brick wall and we decided, hey, let's build Go now. We've been preparing for this over the past year or so. So we saw this coming, so which is the reason why we've been building it, and we've completed the Go-based ICON 2.0 system early this year, or a couple of months ago. So this means that we can cut the future development time. So it'll be much faster for us to develop, going forward. Secondly, we will see a huge improvement with the performance due to the higher code efficiency. So Go is very popular for something like blockchain because it is very, you know, it is a much a better language for us to work with. Stability has been another key issue, and Go is supposed to do exactly what you code. There's no surprises while you programming with Go. It's more manageable at scale when architecture becomes more complicated. So, which is where we are, frankly, with ICON. ICON has been in development for years, and you know, we've integrated a lot of governance features, token and economic features, and we're continually adding new features into ICON. So, you know, as you add more features, you know, Python base has been, you know, more or less getting more and more unstable. Whereas Go, you know, it gives us that kind of flexibility to add in a lot of these features while keeping the entire system like extremely stable. And lastly, which kind of goes related to both scalability and stability, is that Go has a top-notch debugging tools. So it's much easier for us to audit the codes that we built, the features that we build. And this also adds for faster development and more stable code.
Now, what's the timeline for 2.0? My understanding is it's being launched in phases and comes out next year.
Yeah, so the testnet is already, so the code is already built, it's live on GitHub. The testnet is live. We have developers that are already on there and, you know, on the test, going in and playing with the testnet mode. But you gotta, you know, but there's a lot of data that needs to be migrated, a lot of the features that needs to be migrated to this new blockchain engine. So we're taking that very slowly and cautiously. And the first phase we want to do beginning of next year, and the second phase we're going to do in the middle of next year. So we're hoping by mid to 2021, the entire engine will be switched to Icon 2.0.
All right, that's great news. Looking forward to it.